Hi, welcome to today's episode of Revenge is Sweet. I'll be your host, Mark. Follow me today as we venture through the life of one young Teddy the Clown. Although his life may be short-lived, the adventures it brought him are hard to compare. Walk with me. Teddy didn't have what you'd call a normal childhood experience. When he was just 1 week old, his parents were beaten to death by children in a suburban neighborhood. You could say he was born to be beaten, but he wanted to be greater. He didn't want to be part of his parents' legacy. So, from a young age, he entered into the criminal lifestyle, smiling and looking colorful by day, and vandalizing by night. So, Teddy's had many adventures in the past, but one tops all. We like to call it here, the big one. What I'm talking about is T-Pain, toilet paper. In the trees, on the lawn, in the bushes. Teddy was caught there in the morning. So, today is the day of his execution. Come join me as we watch Teddy being burned. Welcome to the end of today's episode where we finally meet our culprit, Teddy the Clown. The question is, Teddy, any last words? But looks like Teddy's partner in crime, Lucas Franklin, hasn't shown up to save his pal. Typical. Well, here we are, folks, the moment we've been waiting for. As for me, I'm gonna sit back, relax, and enjoy some Cracker Jacks.
Look at that, we've got a little smoke hole up at the top. How convenient. Let's try a little extra flint. Insects.
Shout out to Lucas Franklin. Pinatas were made for beating. Kids, that concludes today's episode of Revenge is Sweet, starring Teddy the Clown. Join us next time. Well, we don't know if there'll be a next time, and who could top that? Here's a tissue for your tears, dear Lucas.